What if the Roman Empire existed in 1444? Hi everyone, and welcome to today's video where we're going to be checking out what would happen if the Roman Empire existed in 1444. Before we begin, consider leaving a like and subscribing since only 12% of you are subscribed, and you can become a member today. So as you can see, it's December 1st, 1444, and I've formed the Roman Empire at its peak borders in 117 AD. And these borders may not be 100% accurate. I did use this image as well as this image, and there may be a mistake here and there in about maximum 5 provinces, to be honest. So this is pretty much as accurate as it gets, in my opinion. They have a ruler. He is a 402 Imperator Bardas the First Cassia, and he's kind-hearted as well as balanced, and they are officially Catholic. Of course, they are number one on the Great Powers list with 4,838 development, about 4 times as much as Ming, and their capital is of course in Rome. Now, they do have a ton of troops right now. Of course, they will downsize. This is only due to the fact that I integrated nations, so they will destroy these ships and units until they stabilize their economy. So what do you guys think will happen? Leave a comment below with your predictions. Will they continue to expand? Will they stay like this? Will they collapse like it happened in real life? Or will they just stagnate and not expand as much? If we click on their show diplomatic feedback button, we can see the provinces that they desire. The HRE of course does still exist, so we'll see what the power dynamic will be between them and the Roman Empire. And who do you think will be their biggest rival? I'm thinking Russia personally, if Muscovy managed to form them. So let's let the game run and check back in about 30 to 40 years. So as you can see, it's been about 40 years. It's 1486, and let's take a look at what the Roman Empire has been up to. Basically, they've taken over some provinces in the Maghreb, these 3 right here, as well as these 3 right here. They did full annex Austria. Austria was left with these 2 provinces right here, Lentia and Mönchengladbach. They did full annex them. Remember how they were interested in the entire Crimea area? Well, they have taken these provinces over. They only had these ones right here, but they've taken over about 7 or 8 more. And Crimea is now down to just 1 province. They have also expanded in the Persia region as well, taking over these 4 provinces as well as this one right here. And they did get into a war with whichever nation was here, but basically they got Medina, Yanbu, and these 3 provinces as well. So they have been expanding at a rate which I expected them to. Pretty much. They did also manage to vassalize Moldavia, and they're already integrating them actually, and they're also receiving trade power from Gelray as well as Tafilalt down here, and I do think they might make them into vassals as well, although I don't know about Tafilalt. They are kind of big right now. They have also been converting some provinces, well at least the Orthodox ones, to Catholic, as we can notice right here in the Bosnia and Serbia areas, as well as this one province right here. And I do think they will continue to convert at least the Orthodox provinces. They have even converted 2 in their subject Moldavia. Another interesting thing is that Bohemia, they did become Hussite, and there are some other Hussite provinces here in Lithuania and Poland too. And of course there is a center of Reformation. They haven't had any rebel or vassal releasing problems yet. Their previous ruler did die, and they have a new one now. This guy is an administrator, so that means that they don't really want to conquer, well, almost any provinces. They only want to take Rhodes from the knights, which I do think I forgot to give them a mistake, and they also want to conquer the Isles as well as some provinces in Scotland. So maybe as long as they have this ruler, and he is pretty young, only 19, they probably won't expand as much. Of course, they do have the biggest army in the world with 459,000 troops almost. They're kind of low on manpower though, only 17k, and about half of their army is mercstacks. They have 260 mercenaries, and they also took economic and diplomatic ideas for their first 2 idea groups. Elsewhere in the world, Muscovy is growing pretty big, and they will definitely form Russia. Poland and Lithuania are expanding a bit too. Everything seems normal in Asia as well as in Africa. Let's see who decides to colonize though. So now it's 1531, about 50 years since we last checked in, and the Roman Empire has been expanding more than I thought actually. So moving up to the British Isles, they have taken a few provinces from Scotland and the Isles, these 3 provinces here specifically, and they have cleaned up some of the nations that were remaining in this area right here. They're not going for Tafilalt because they're actually allied. Going over to this region, they have expanded quite a bit, so they took these 5 provinces from Lithuania obviously, and they took some provinces over here from the Great Horde, some other minor nations, as well as full annexing Circassia. I'm still triggered they didn't connect their lands. They also did some minor expansion into these Persian nations right here, having gotten some provinces from Ajam mainly. And they've also moved down here, and they have expanded quite a lot into Arabia actually. If you remember last time, they were about here, but they have full annexed a ton of nations like Najd, Dawasir, Medina, and nations like that. And they've even moved into Yemen down here. They now have a ruler that is balanced, so this guy will be declaring more wars than the previous two rulers, who were actually administrators. And these are the lands they desire right now. As we can see, some more provinces from Scotland, Morocco, they want to full annex them, Spain. And they're very interested in a ton of provinces in Arabia, Persia, as well as the Pontic Steppe here in the Horus, just like in the beginning. Now, I don't know what exactly causes them to want these lands. Maybe they want some strategic trade goods. Maybe they're interested in taking over larger parts of these trade nodes, or maybe they just hate those nations, to be honest. But either way, they have been doing even more religious conversion, by the way. They've almost converted the entire Balkans, with the exception of southern Greece here, and they've started converting Anatolia too. I didn't think they would start converting Muslim lands so soon though, but either way, that's going great for them. And the Protestant Reformation did spawn in Brandenburg, if I'm not mistaken, and a ton of nations have actually converted. We do have three Protestant centers of Reformation and two Reformed centers of Reformation, as far as I can see. So that's not going very well for the HRE, and they're losing a ton of imperial authority because the Roman Empire still holds on to some of their territories right here. Oh yeah, Scotland's Emperor. They have also taken offensive ideas for their third idea group. Now elsewhere in the world, Muscovy is expanding quite a bit. They have been pushing into Lithuania and some other nations right here. And Poland actually doesn't have Lithuania in a PU, and Denmark integrated Norway, but they don't have Sweden. By the way, Denmark has also taken exploration ideas. And once again, some things never change. Castile is still colonizing. Castile and Portugal do exist. So Castile exists in these two islands right here, and Portugal exists right here. I guess they're not rich enough to colonize though. But either way, we do have some Danish colonies in North America and some Castilian colonies in South America. Everything else seems normal in Africa. Ethiopia is enjoying a good game. In India, Bahmanis, Orissa, and Delhi are dominating. Ming is pretty big and they haven't collapsed, and Janzhu has formed Manchu. So the Roman Empire is definitely ramping up in expansion, and they are desiring a lot more provinces than they were about 20 to 30 years ago. So let's see how far they can push. They're making 766 ducats a month, and they have 660,000 troops. Of course, they're number one with 5.5k development. They started out with 4.8k. So now it's 1580, almost the age of absolutism. But not having absolutism didn't stop the Roman Empire from expanding. In fact, they have expanded quite a lot. They've taken some provinces down here from Ethiopia, and they've cleaned up some of the miners over here in Arabia, even going as far as this province right here and taking the island of Hormuz. It's pretty annoying to conquer this. I guess they have ships over in this side of the world as well, but they have also moved into Persia quite a bit. As we can see, they've taken over all of these provinces as well as all of these provinces over here, and they've even moved up to the east coast of the Caspian Sea. That's not all, they have also expanded in this direction even more into the Great Horde, and now the Great Horde is down to just five provinces. They also went to war with Poland and Lithuania again, still not taking this province, but they took a bunch of land over here. If you remember, they only had these three provinces, so they took all of this. They also got in some wars with the HRE, just minor ones. As we can see, they have taken these two provinces right here from Bohemia, and they've even taken these two provinces, I'm assuming, from Friesland. Strange that they haven't connected them, but well, the AI is gonna do AI stuff. I was gonna say Lannister is about to form Ireland, but I don't think they're gonna get this province. And that's pretty much what they look like right now. They have been doing a ton of religious conversion. I mean, look how far they've gotten with converting. They're doing it non-stop all the time and pretty successfully. This is how the Protestant Reformation is going. They have a pretty big chunk, to be honest. Almost all of the HRE is Protestant, as well as Hungary right here, but of course it is about to stop pretty soon. They have of course upgraded the St. Peter's Basilica in Rome to tier 3, and they've even moved Stonehenge over here, although they haven't worked on it. They actually have been doing some very cursed culture conversion, and if we click on the Roman culture, well, this is pretty much what they converted. I don't know why they did this. Maybe these provinces were the cheapest, or maybe these were the only ones that they could convert, but they they have been doing culture conversion, and this is what the Roman culture looks like. For their fourth idea group, they have taken innovative ideas, and they're at war with Denmark and Castile right now, although I don't think that these are their wars, actually. Elsewhere in the world, Russia is expanding. They are getting pretty big. Ming is not doing too bad either. Ethiopia is still pretty big, even though they suffered a loss to the Roman Empire. And Malacca isn't doing too bad either. Castile is doing pretty well in the colonization department. They have Brazil and Argentina, as well as provinces down here in South Africa, and provinces in the Caribbean as well, with some Portuguese ones too. The North American natives are starting to get big. The Roman Empire are sitting at 6,200 development right now. They did start off with 4,800. They have 750,000 troops, and they're making 840 ducats a month. And we'll check back in once again when the Age of Absolutism hits. So it's almost 1640, well into the Age of Absolutism, and let's take a look at what everyone has been up to. Of course, the Roman Empire have been expanding quite a bit. They finally managed to clean up the entire Maghreb region. I'm guessing their alliance with Tafilalt right here broke somehow, and after that they didn't ally again, and they just ate them up. Remember how I said Lannister might form Ireland? Yeah, that didn't happen. They've also been expanding in the Netherlands area as well, cleaning up some of these minor nations, but other than that, they haven't been pushing into the HRE too much. They have taken over this entire region as well, and they were in a war with Russia, although the Roman Empire didn't declare on Russia. They were just on different sides in some random war, and actually, wait, they're in a war with Russia right now. So they're fighting against Denmark, Vinland, Danish Columbia, and Russia in the Swedish reconquest of Norcod. So yeah, Sweden declared on Denmark, and the Roman Empire is allied to Sweden. But either way, they've also been cleaning up Arabia. As you can see, they own almost all of Arabia, with just this southern portion right here owned by Ethiopia. They haven't been in another war with Ethiopia since the last one. And they have been pushing further into Persia. We got some wonderful border right here. Why does the AI take these provinces? Does it have some strategic interest in them? I don't know. But they might be reaching India soon, so we'll see what happens with that. And Afghanistan has split into two, but they are pretty big. And we have some more border gore right here, pushing into Transoxiana and Nogai. And that's pretty much the extent of their conquest so far. Russia is pretty huge as well. Manchu is doing pretty well, to be honest, and Japan has formed. And Ming is pretty big too. They're fighting a war against Oirat right now. Bahmanis is dominating India, and Malacca is doing pretty good as well. Castile has immigrated to South Africa, and this is actually their capital now, but they're still doing pretty good. They own this entire area, and they have a bunch of colonies like Argentina, Brazil, the Caribbean, and even Louisiana and New Scotland, of course. I thought that was Florida, to be honest. But the natives are doing really good as well. Wichita is pretty big, and so is Algonquin. And we have Danish Columbia too. They have taken espionage ideas for their fifth idea group. Hey, sometimes you gotta spy on them. And they have been continuing their religious conversion as well. That's going pretty well for them. They haven't touched North Africa though. I wonder why they're pushing into here. And of course, since it is the Age of Absolutism, the Protestant Reformation has ended, and this is what it turned out to look like. They have also been doing even more culture conversion, and this is what the Roman culture looks like right now. And these are the lands that they desire for some reason, so I guess we'll continue seeing them push in this direction. And it has been almost 200 years since the start of the game. They are an economic hegemon, obviously at full strength, and they have grown by about 2,500 development. They started out at 4,800. So let's see what the next couple of decades hold for us. So now it's 1686, almost the age of revolutions, and the Roman Empire has been expanding even more. I mean, just take a look at this. They've taken over the entire Persia region, as we can see right here, and they've basically taken over the entire Khorasan region as well, with the exception of a few provinces here. But they're in a war with Sindh and Gujarat right now in the Roman Sindhi Imperial War, so they do have imperialism, and they're gonna ramp up expansion even more now. But they've also been expanding in the Central Asia region as well, pushing into all the hordes and just cleaning up all the smaller nations that they can find, and even some bigger ones too. This is actually the main region where they have been expanding, with not a lot of stuff going on in North Africa, mainland Europe, and the British Isles. They have taken some provinces from Poland and Lithuania though, and they have also constructed the Suez Canal. But that's not all. They also have Hungary and Castile somehow. They did have the same dynasty as Hungary. Well, they actually still do, but they got Castile as well. Now, Castile, if you guys remember, they did emigrate to South Africa, and they do have a ton of colonies. They did actually lose their biggest colony, which was Argentina, and this did happen while they were in a personal union under the Roman Empire. But they still have a ton of other colonies. As we can see right here, they have 6 colonies, and this is what North America looks like. Russia has actually shrunk a bit due to the Roman Empire expanding a bit into them, and now they don't really have anywhere to go. They are surrounded by a lot of strong nations. They could probably push into Manchu though. Ming is expanding quite a bit. This is actually quite unusual for them. They usually don't expand a whole lot and just get tributaries, but they have expanded here and over here as well. Bahmanis is still the dominant power in India, but with the Roman Empire moving in, I don't know how long it will stay like that. They have also started converting some provinces in Africa finally. Right now, the Roman Empire has 1.4 million troops with a force limit of 2,200. I mean, Ming is second and they barely have 300,000 troops. They're making 1,900 ducats a month. And the most valuable trade node is Genoa, followed by Novgorod and Astrakhan for some reason. Of course, there is zero retained value since everyone is pushing in their respective trade nodes. So that's how things are going so far. Let's see if the Roman Empire can rack up a few more personal unions, and will we have some revolutionary nations in the age of revolutions? Bruh, it's 1730 and this is what the Roman Empire looks like. Obviously, they have integrated Castile. So let's take a look at everything they've done. Over here in the general area, which they started out with, of course, they have managed to, well, almost fully conquer the British Isles. They don't have Man yet, and they don't have these islands, which are still owned by Denmark. Yes, Scandinavia and Denmark exist at the same time. They also managed to take over some more provinces over here, although they have left some border lore right here. Their main area of expansion was still Central Asia, as well as Khorasan and parts of India as well. As we can see, they have expanded quite a bit over here, and they've also pushed quite heavily into India, and they even own Delhi. Let's see if they're brave enough to take on Bahmanis though, since they are really strong, and this is actually the biggest I've seen a nation in India become in one of these AI only games. They've also taken some more provinces from Ethiopia finally, and they have almost all of Arabia, with the exception of these provinces of course. And they've even moved further into the Horn of Africa. Moving into Southern Africa, they have taken over these provinces right here. Of course, they had some here and there, but I guess they did decide to attack some nations over here. They do have a colony in Australia, of course. This is due to Castile. And they have some other provinces here and there, like this one right here and this one right here. This is what South America looks like. Still only Castilian Brazil, but another colony is about to form in the Argentina region. And this is what North America looks like. As we can see, a bunch of colonial nations, but there are still native nations present. In the subjects, we can see that they actually have like 8 tributary states for some reason. They're all North American nations. I don't know why they're tributaries though. They do have a vassal, one of this nation right here. And of course, they have their colonial nations, these 8. So they definitely have been expanding quite a lot. Most of their wars were actually in the New World, and they were feeding their colonies, but they were expanding over here and over here as well. They're only allied to Scandinavia, and they do have the same dynasty, so we may see a potential for some PUs between them. They have also been converting even more, of course. The revolution has popped up in the Roman Empire. This is the center of revolution right here, and this is what it has converted so far in this region, but then it seems to have jumped to Scandinavia for some reason. So let's see if Scandinavia becomes revolutionary, or maybe even the Roman Empire. Will they revert back to the Roman Republic? And we'll jump back in about 50 years. So now it's 1781, and you can see what the Roman Empire have been doing even just from a first glance. Basically, their main route of expansion has still been in Asia, and they have been pushing into India and even into Ming and Russia as well. So this is their border with Bahmanis and Bengal right now. In fact, they just got out of a war with Bahmanis. As you can see, look at all these armies that they have stacked in here. There's probably more than 1 million troops over here in this area, and of course Bahmanis lost. This is where they have gotten so far. This is what their border with Ming looks like. They did get into a couple of wars with Ming, and they have pushed into them quite a lot. As you can see, Manchu also fell quite a bit to Ming and Japan and Russia as well. Japan have expanded quite substantially. This is how far the Roman Empire has gotten into its border with Russia, and they do keep declaring on Russia as well. Not much changes in Europe. They have taken some more provinces over here, but these are just minor changes compared to the huge expansion they have been doing in Asia. Remember, when they started out, their border was about here, and they've conquered more than double what they started out with. They have also pushed into Ethiopia even more, and we can see they have some separatists right here, but they did clean up Arabia, and they have pushed down into the Horn of Africa even further. I don't think there are any changes in Africa, maybe a couple of provinces over here, but they have been expanding over here too. We have a Roman Indonesia, so they own some provinces on Sumatra and Borneo as well, and a couple of scattered provinces right here. Tierra Austral is looking pretty good, and of course we have Danish Papuan Peninsula. This isn't them, by the way, this is this New Zealand nation. This is what South America looks like. Not much changes from when we last checked in, but we can notice Scotland right here. They actually emigrated to the New World. As we can see, this is their capital. This is the only province they have, and they do still have a colony, New Scotland, which is right here, and they too only have one province. In fact, New Scotland is more powerful than Scotland, but this is some pretty cursed stuff. We also have Danish Peru and Danish Colombia. They've pretty much cleaned up North America with the exception of two strong nations that remain, Algonquin and Mi'kmaq, and some other minor ones that they probably don't even know exist, so they haven't conquered them yet. And of course, New Scotland. So this is what they pretty much look like right now. Of course, the revolution fizzled out. No one became revolutionary. Duh. Right now, they're sitting at 14.7k development. As we know, they started out with 4.8k, which means they have almost tripled in size. But we only have one more jump until the end of the game, so let's see what their final borders will look like. And now it's 1821, basically the end date, and the Roman Empire just casually has a 547k stack sitting in Rome, as well as a 739 ship stack. But let's see what they've been up to. Basically, this is the extent of the Roman Empire, and they have expanded massively. Of course, you know the classic borders that they started out with. In Northern Europe, they took over some provinces over here in the Netherlands and Germany, as well as finishing off Scotland and the Irish nations, but they didn't get mad. They also cleaned up some other nations that were left in the Maghreb region, like Morocco, their vassals, and the minor nations south of Tunis. In this area of Africa, they did sort of expand down the coast and slightly into the Horn of Africa, but not too much expansion in this region. Basically, Ethiopia prospered the whole game, only taking a few losses. Their Arabian border was right here, and of course, they did manage to take over all of Arabia. But even though they didn't expand too much into Europe, of course, they did take over Carpathia and provinces over here from Poland and Lithuania. Their main route of expansion was into Asia, conquering all of Persia, Khorasan, some Indian regions, Central Asia, Mongolia, Tibet, and even reaching as far as this coastline over here. They've pushed well into China and well into India. They also have a few provinces over here in the Indonesian islands. Now, this is thanks to the fact that they got Castile in a PU, inherited some provinces from them in here, and they did expand into some minor nations, not into the strong ones like Malacca, for example. Oh, Portugal is here. Where's their capital? And their capital is right here, actually, in the province of West Timor. You know, some things never change. Speaking of colonies, they have Tierra Austral. This is what South America looks like. They have Castilian Brazil, as well as some other provinces over here. This is where Scotland exists now, in Vila Bella. Chile was Argentina, a colony of Castile. Now they're independent. We also have Peru and Colombia. I think these broke free from Denmark. We have New Castile, Castilian West Indies, New Roman Empire, Louisiana, and Alaska, pretty much, as well as California. There are some strong natives like Algonquin and Mi'kmaq. They also inherited some provinces from Castile in South Africa, and they have expanded in the coastline slightly right here and right here. And that is pretty much how much they've grown. They did convert a ton, even though they don't have religious ideas. So basically, pretty much they converted almost everywhere that they conquered, except the Coptic provinces over here and some Sunni provinces in the Maghreb region, and the fetishist ones right here too. But almost all of South America is Catholic, and most of Asia as well. If this game went on for 2 or 3 more hundred years, they would achieve a world conquest and a one faith too. They did try out for a one culture though, a bit, even though it was unsuccessful. Basically, this is the extent of the Roman culture. They were converting slightly, and this is everything that they have converted to Roman in Europe. They have some provinces in Africa too. All of Southern Africa is Roman, a few provinces in South America, and a few in North America as well, and a couple in Indonesia. And now I just tagged into them to see things from their perspective. So these are basically all their subjects, as we can see right here. They have a bunch of trade companies. They have one vassal and a bunch of tributary states. These are all North American nations. And these are all their colonies. New Castile is disloyal. Damn, these guys are brave. They're making 3,000 ducats a month. This is their income. 800 in tax, 2,500 in production, and 1,000 in trade. And the rest they did manage to construct the Suez Canal. Apparently, they have negative 444,000 soldiers, I guess maybe because they're over a million and there's an overflow or something, but their force limit is 6k. They also managed to push Rome to 168 development, and they did move every monument they could to here. Of course, it does start with St. Peter's Basilica, but they moved the Stonehenge here from England, Buddha statues from the Timurids, and the Moai from Easter Island. Of course, they did start out with 4,800 dev, and now they're at 16k. Basically, they've grown by over 3 times, and they're also an economic hegemon, and they've been one for quite a while. So, to answer the question, what would happen if the Roman Empire existed in 1444? Well, basically, they would blob like crazy. Honestly, I didn't actually expect this. I did expect them to grow a bit and maybe collapse, release some vassals, lose land to rebels, and stuff like that. Since the AI isn't that competent at expanding this much, you know, I did a what if Italy or what if Germany existed, and they didn't grow too big. But I guess this was an exception, and I'm interested in seeing how other militarily focused and conquest focused nations would fare in these what if scenarios. So leave a comment for the next what if scenario that you would like to see, and I am preparing what if every religion was a nation, so stay tuned for that. If you enjoyed this video, consider leaving a like and subscribing, since only 12% of you are subscribed, and you can become a member today and join the Discord. The link is in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time with another EU4 video.